Yes, hi everyone, welcome back. This is a sequence video that we did about the databases earlier, right? So having said that, understood about the databases, I hope so. So let's move to the next part, where how can I use that different databases and understand the literature review process. Okay, so let's start. So we open the databases that we already kept ready. So for any literature review, the first thing to identify your research area. For that, we require keywords to be typed into the database. Let us understand. I opened the Emerald Insight database now, and I'm just start typing. I would like to know the relationship between economic growth. Let's say economic growth means GDP growth, and tourism growth, how both are related. And if I start typing economic growth, see, some automatic suggestions they are giving, but we ignore it as of now. So economic growth, tourism, and I want the relation between the two. Economic growth, tourism, relation. I want this particular topic has been studied by a method of regression. So I am using the keyword regression. Let us see with these keywords what type of articles I can get through this particular database. When you hit search button, there are about 2000 articles which are giving the keywords, like I have mentioned tourism. So I have mentioned one of the word as tourism, so it is giving related to that. Then again one more article. If you look at the kind of industries, that this is about the leisure and hospitality industries. And the second paper, as you can see, it is related to airlines. Now if you can see tourism specialization and economic output, now the keywords both are included in this paper. Like that, you have to search for your article. Let us open one of the article for your understanding. The tourism-led growth hypothesis, the Lebanese case. So we displayed 10 articles per page, we can display further 10. Let us see how different articles are coming out. The geopolitics of future tourism development in an expanding EU, European Union. So different multiple papers across industries related to this agri-tourism, agriculture and economic growth. Okay. So let us see view summary and detail, understand now. So in Emerald database, there is a format to be followed called as the abstract, which is giving you the primary and basic details of the paper. So in this, the abstract consists of purpose. Purpose is nothing but what actually this particular paper is meant for. So the purpose of this paper is to assess the role of agriculture and economic growth and its interaction with other sectors of the Tunisian economy. So not only the tourism, but also the other sectors, how they are related with the economic growth has been studied in this paper. So this paper has used regression, because I have typed the regression as one of my particular method. So depending on the search keywords, whatever you mention along with the keywords, like economic growth and the tourism, the regression is also one of the keyword. That's why this particular article has come out of the database. So if I am interested in this particular research paper, I just first study what is the purpose of this and what actually the methodology they have used. So Johansson's multivariate approach is used to study the co-integration of the different sectors of the economy. So this is the method, which is advanced statistical method. Then they have mentioned about the methodology, how they have done it. Then the crucial one is nothing but the findings. What actually this study had given the results? What type of results this study had given? So the empirical results suggest that all Tunisian economic sectors co-integrate and tend to move together. So some result they are giving this particular study has. And the originality, that mean to say every article, every research article has its original. Originality meaning that you have not copied somebody's work. So you have to show them that you have used good reference literature review and come out with your own study. That's why it is always the research paper should be highlighted with what kind of value or originality your paper is giving with. What is the contribution of your paper, in other words, to the entire literature review. So to add to this further, we'll go to the different other papers as you can see. Okay, so we move to the next database. So economic growth, tourism, relation, regression, right? So these are the keywords I have used here. Now the same keywords I am using in the database Scopus. It is only for your understanding I am making this video, so I am using the same keywords. Now this particular economic growth, tourism, relation, regression is to be searched in title, abstract and keywords. So I am taking all fields for that and search. So I am searching documents, as you can see. Now it will give the list of articles with the keywords that I have mentioned. So the important thing here is that putting the right keywords, it's like a data mining, we can say, in statistics. So it is both art and science of putting the right words into the database mouth so that it gives the relevant results to us. Okay, so as you can see, this database has how many articles? As you can see from here, open access 388 1817. Oh, huge database. Okay, so let us see. The first article in this is mentioned tourism and economic growth, a meta regression analysis. So if one can interested about the tourism and economic growth, one can go through these type of articles. So let us understand one of the article. Research note: tourism and economic growth in Latin American countries, further empirical evidence. So let us see the abstract first here. See, here the abstract means in Scopus it gives you the overall idea in a paragraph. Unlike in the Emerald database, in the Emerald database the abstract meaning that they have let me show you one more. Abstract means purpose, design and methodology, approach and also findings, research limitation, implication. So let me add for your understanding the purpose. In fact, this is introduction purpose. So I am adding these things to give you a framework. Okay, at the end you will understand what I am trying to say. Then findings. So let us put all these words in a paper and understand one by one when we go through the entire research process. So I am keeping this entire wording as it is so that you will get the idea of basically how a research paper constitutes different ingredients into it. Okay, so So let's see how this Now, as I mentioned, the Emerald database has its own abstract format, whereas Scopus gives you the abstract format in the database, saying that it is in a paragraph, it gives you the overall idea of the paper. So let us see this particular paper now. Using panel data spanning from 90 to 2005, the authors investigate the impact of tourism on the economic growth of 18 heterogeneous Latin American countries. So economic growth and tourism is the main keywords we have used. So this particular paper is identifying these two variables have been studied over a period of time by using the methodology. Results from the empirical model show that revenues from the tourism industry contribute positively to both the current level and the growth rate of per capita GDP of the countries in the region. So basically this is the result they have got. So the findings implied that the Latin American economies may enhance their economic growth in the short run by strengthening their tourism industry strategically. So while not neglecting the traditional sources of economic growth. So this is the particular result attributed to this particular study. So going through the abstract itself, one can get the clear idea about that particular paper. So that's why knowing these databases is a very, very important step in the research process. Okay, so we'll move to the next one, EBSCOhost. The same keywords I'm using. Sorry, I think I have to take the same keywords here. Sorry for that. Let's continue. EBSCOhost, the same keyword. I am giving you only the idea of using the same keywords for your understanding. So EBSCOhost also is a good database. Let us see how many articles it will throw us. I think some problem occurred. Okay. So let me pause this video and one more time, you log into your EBSCO, it shows the beginning screen like this and select the databases. Once you are inside the databases, it will ask for the search. So we just enter the keywords, like I mentioned, the same keywords I have mentioned. So depending on the different databases, the search results may vary. Some of them may give 1000 articles, some of them may give few hundreds. So let us see. So around 4600 articles have come. So in this also different articles have been mentioned. But here the format is a little different. Let us say the analysis of the relation between education and economic growth. So here to not tourism related economic growth, so we can ignore this. So like that, one can go through the relevant articles, and based on mind you that based on your keywords only these results have come. Okay, so find any of my search terms. So this is another option that you may use it. So this is basically an idea to give you how to use the databases using keywords. Then we move to the Web of Science. This is also another database with the same keywords I'm using. So I'm searching these keywords in the topic, or I may suggest in the title of the paper or publication name of the paper, etc. But I am going by topic as of now. So let us see. If you notice, the keywords I am using specifically two variables which are I am interested to know. One is economic growth and tourism, and the word relation I have used, and the methodology where I can use some statistical technique, that is I mentioned as a regression. So basically you try to understand, if you want to get the right articles, you have to enter the right keywords, including the methodology keywords like the application of tools like regression, ANOVA, right, etc. So let us understand the economic impact of tourism moratoria in the Canary Island This is Journal of Sustainable Tourism. Okay, so whichever article you are interested, just you have to click and see what kind of a result they have got it. Okay, so don't worry about the methodology, because there are some advanced statistics has been used in different research articles. You don't have to worry for that. Once you select a good research topic, then I will help you out with the statistical calculations and the results. Not a big issue. Okay, so let us look into that. Right, as you can see, this Web of Science had given few articles with the highlighted keywords. So let us see determinants of international business tourism. Okay, so let us check this abstract. So here they had given about the business tourism, right? Business tourism is a tourist segment in great growth that has given the countries a multitude of benefits of economic, social and cultural nature. So in this context, what they have done, see, the literature review identified the variables controllable by the action of institutional actors of business, and sample consist destinations, and enable the estimation of a multiple regression model using the eView software. You may use, instead of eViews, SPSS also you can use. So the resulting data from 136 countries they have taken for the period 2005 to 2009. So every paper has in the abstract mentioning the key parts of the paper. See, it is about the introduction about the topic, literature review, how they have done the particular study, that is called the design or methodology or approach. Then once you design how you are going to study about your particular topic of research, that is mentioned in the methodology part. The methodology part is nothing but what time span your data, what type of data that you are using, whether you are using primary data or secondary data. All these papers that I have shown now, these are all taken secondary data, because they have mentioned the time frame and what data they have taken. 136 countries worldwide they have taken the data on both the variables, economic growth and tourism. So these data has been extracted from where, sir? They have mentioned and stemmed from the World Travel and Tourism Council and World Bank databases. So this is what I am trying to say, this is how they have got the data, and they use the different tools, statistical tools, to analyze the data. So that all together comes under methodology or the approach. Three names you may use in place of one another. So findings, meaning that once you have done the data analysis, your findings, what are the results that you have got, what actually you found from this particular study. And the next comes the limitations or the implication. That means by this study, by doing this study, what actually the benefits, implications. So sometimes you may say it may be used for best policy decision, or you may say that this particular research study is limited by only for taking a particular time period. So limitations are many, as such the implications also. So implications are nothing but what actually using this particular study, what actually you are aiming at a particular policy decisions. Then the originality value, as I mentioned, every research has its own unique output. So obviously every research paper efforts into its originality or the value that it contributes. So now we'll go back to the databases. Now I'll be showing you further how to do the literature review. Okay, so this is how about the databases to keep the ready different article. So I am going with each one, but I will focus in one of the databases so that you know, you will understand better. Okay, so we see to the Scopus database. Okay, The same can be followed in the others also, but I will try to explain in all of them. Okay, so let's see. So let's start with the reference management software called Mendeley. As I have mentioned already, you must have downloaded Mendeley software into your desktop or laptop, whatever, but the PC version is called Mendeley Desktop. So it is already installed in my laptop, so I am opening it. You also keep it ready in your laptop. So once I open that Mendeley software, the beginning screen looks like it's already so I have already done it. So it will give me the entire research articles which are already been collected from different databases. So I'll be showing you now how to, as you can see the screen, see all documents I have downloaded these all articles from the databases of these kind only. So I'll be showing now how to do that. Okay, so let us start. So since I have already made this particular Mendeley for a certain purpose, so I'll be showing you the entire new one for you. Okay, so let us start with that. So for that I am creating a new library for me. Okay, so let's start with the Mendeley. In Mendeley, when you open it should not show like this actually. So for that, what I will do is I just delete my files and I will show you. I'll do one thing. Let us show you how to get the articles out of the database to the Mendeley. Okay, so let us start with that. Simple. Let us say I just want to know this particular paper want to be seen in the reference management software. So for that I just need to click it, this particular. Now as you can see, there are different buttons are there. As you can see, CSV export. Now once you click it, you will notice that here the entire export settings have been clearly mentioned that I am using one of the software Mendeley. If I am not using Mendeley, instead of that I am using EndNote, because EndNote is a paid software whereas Mendeley is a complete open source free software. So we are using Mendeley, not EndNote, so that's why it is Mendeley is highlighted in the selection. Now what I want from this particular selection is that let's say suppose if I want to take any other databases, then these are all highlighted. So let me check and go back once again. Let me check. Okay, let us see how this save to Mendeley is work. Okay, let's start exporting this particular paper to the Mendeley. Okay, so just click it here, select the Mendeley, then export. So once you open this export document settings, instead of choosing Mendeley directly, choose RIS format. Okay, then export. It will ask to open with what software. I want other software that is called Mendeley. Okay, So since I have both EndNote and both, that's why it has come like that. But you can choose the desktop. Okay, open with Mendeley desktop. Once you open that paper, the Mendeley automatically opens because we have selected that. See, the article has pop up already in the top. Tourism and Economic Growth, a Meta Regression Analysis. Now you can clearly see, and it is added just now. Okay, so how to use this particular reference software in the literature is very simple. Just as you can see, it is already highlighted here. It is the journal article, the title and different authors, and the abstract with the keywords they have used in the particular research. Now as you can see, this particular Journal of Travel Research, which is recently published, as you can see, numerous studies have focused on delineating the relationship between tourism and economic growth. In this article, we present the results of rigorous meta-regression analysis based on the 545 estimates drawn from 113 studies that empirically tested the tourism-led growth hypothesis. So this is related to economic growth and tourism. So this particular paper is highlighting that they have done the studies. It is actually the study of studies, we can say that. Okay, so this particular research article, if you want to make a reference into your literature review, then how you go about it? Just very simple. Just you have to copy this. Every time when you do the research, this is the process normally you do. Select all, copy, open one Word document, save by any other name, just paste it. So copy paste is the work, but this is not the research, right? So I'm just giving you the idea how to quickly you have to do literature review. So in this paper, they have mentioned the research article, authors, etc., and the reference also they had given. That means where this particular article has been published in Scopus, etc., right? Any notes? Nothing has been highlighted. Contents. Okay, so let us see further. Yes, so having understood how to download the paper into the reference management software, just copy pasted the abstract, then right click, mark as, sorry, copy as, formatted citation, then come to the article where you have pasted it, just reference, paste. So every time, this is the procedure how you have to make your literature review quickly. So in this, what we have to do is that this is the reference. So this particular study done by these three authors, three or four authors, in the year 2020. Journal name is Tourism and Economic Growth. Pardon. This is the title of the paper or the research article, and the journal is that Journal of Travel Research. This is the Scopus, which is taken from this identifier. We call it DOI identifier. Okay, so one can give the number to this particular article to identify in the databases. This is the identifier address. So given this the reference software usage, now this you have to write this entire abstract. This is the study done by these people. It is not your study. So you cannot take as it is, copy paste from their work. That is called plagiarism, right? We all know about it. So we should not do that. So instead, we understand that this particular work and we write it in our own sentence and try to give this credit to this person, because I'm using this study in my literature review as a base for my own study. That is the idea. Okay, I hope you are understanding what I'm saying. Okay, so how to do that in our own words is that I can write that by going through this, I understand that they have tested about tourism-led growth hypothesis. So I can write saying that I just see the result. The result suggests the presence of publication bias in the literature on this topic. So I can say that this is the work done by, as you can see, ETAL et al. That means Nunku and others in the year 2020 have done some work related to tourism-led growth hypothesis. Suggest that tourism-led growth hypothesis. What they found? This is the hypothesis. Suggests the presence of publication bias in the literature. So they found, suggest that the tourism-led growth hypothesis found biased results in this research. Like that, any topic, whenever you are going through the literature review, you have to copy paste their work in some document and carefully go through what kind of work they have done and write it in your own sentences like this. It is only an example to show how quickly the literature review can be done. Now I'll be showing you one research paper where this particular process has been repeated and form the big the big chunk of literature review. Let us see one paper fully, then you will understand. So I want in Scopus, so let us download one open access paper. Okay, so open access, I want open access means they are available online in the databases as a full document. So let us see one document. Some error has happened. Let us move to another database and check a PDF. It is only to give you the idea of a research paper. I hope everybody had gone through your entire literature review. This is Emerald article. As I have mentioned, they have a different format for the abstract, like I explained earlier, each one of them. Then see the introduction phase. See, these all in the introduction itself, they are mentioning about different works of different authors, as you can see. See, as you can see in the introduction itself, they have mentioned about different authors' work. That means they are giving a strong introduction about the topic by highlighting the others' work in the introduction itself, meaning that there is a lot to learn from the other studies to base your foundation in your own research strong. So as you can see, the introduction itself is covering, then separately the literature review also they have given. See the many studies, the more the literature of a research paper, that shows the strength or the support of the particular background work that you are showing, that my research is backed by so many studies. So like that you can think of this. So introduction, literature review, then we come to the data and method. See, they are the same as the thing that I have mentioned in the design methodology approach, is alternatively the same name actually given for this data set and methods, or data and methodology, or research methods. So depending on the type of journal, the nomenclature may be different, but the idea is same. So data set and methods giving you this particular idea. You can go through later about that entire process, then understand what kind of different data they have used, and once they have mentioned the different statistical tools they have used or any kind of analysis tools, then they come to the results and discussion that what they found in their research. Some papers may be too technical for you, but otherwise select those papers which are you can understand and read it better and convey your ideas better. Okay, so that you have to take care at the initial stage. As you gradually do this process, you will get some experience. See, then conclusion. See, this paper does not mention directly the limitations or implications, but in the abstract they have mentioned. See, that is the idea. See, here practical implications, limitations. So if you go through, you will easily find it, the entire process. So this is how the entire process of literature review can be done. So this is a free software, Mendeley. Okay, just what you have to do, copy paste the abstract, understand the content of the abstract, come here and copy as the formatted citation, then automatically you paste it here. You will get the idea that I have showed already. You have got this, right? So once you understand this particular, how many references they have used at the end. So this is what I am trying to say. This is actually what I have showed here. See, the same as these are all works. So these are all works, like I have showed as one example in the literature review process, how it is to be done. The entire literature review in the paper looks like this. See how many studies they have used. See, as you can see, roughly I can say I can figure out 10, 20, 30 plus 20, 50, more than 40, 50 studies they have used, right? So go through the similar kind of exercise and try to understand it. Okay, if you have anything, you have any doubt, then write to me back. Okay, have a great day. Thank you for watching.